The Germans will head to the polls on September 26th, voting for a new parliament and therewith for a new chancellor. At the German Council on Foreign Relations, we analyzed the German foreign policy before this turning point. In a series of memos, our researchers analyzed the state of affairs and recommend what the German government should undertake. Today, I welcome Shahin Vallée, head of the Geo-Economic Program and an expert on European economic affairs. He calls for a new roadmap for the euro area. But before we come to your recommendations, let us briefly take a look at the past. What is the red thread that you have identified?
Essentially, over the last 10 years, Germany has tried to defend the status quo. It has tried to argue that fiscal rules should not be changed, that they were important. It has tried to somewhat minimize the role that monetary policy should play in European economic policy by minimizing the asset purchases program. And finally, Germany has not made big pushes towards the democratization of the euro area economic governance. And so I think these are like four areas where Germany has been rather conservative when the intellectual and political consensus in Europe was shifting quite dramatically.
Mm-hmm. One can say Europe has Germany has been on the brake, but now you say in your paper that this position is not sustainable. Why is that? Why does Germany have to change?
Yeah, I think what has become clear, in particular with the COVID crisis, is that the architecture of the euro area needed to change profoundly so that the euro area could respond to shocks like the COVID crisis. So fiscal rules were all suspended across Europe, but also in Germany, showing that there was a problem with these rules and that they did not have enough flexibility, inbuilt flexibility. Fiscal integration also had to take a leap. As you remember, the German government resisted it, ended up accepting a large recovery and resilience facility, which was the first large common issuance and transfer facility between member states. You remember also that there was a big debate around monetary policy and an important ruling by the German Constitutional Court that tried to limit the role of the public sector purchases program of the ECB, which was eventually struck down by the European Court of Justice, but which was a potential source of conflict between Germany and the rest of Europe. So all of these issues point to an economic architecture that needs to evolve and that needs to evolve profoundly, and for which the next German government and the next Bundestag needs to have a strong mandate.
Talking about the German government, we will have elections coming up in the end of September. Which party promises the most euro-economic reforms?
All parties have been, in my mind, too conservative in this regard. And there is a sort of, consensus that the status quo is sustainable. Perhaps the German Greens have been promoting more aggressively the need for reforms of the debt brake, the Schuldenbremse. But they have done so in a very narrow German way, and they haven't thought very much about what this means for the European fiscal rules. It has been mostly a national debate. So I don't think there's one party that has a clearer view than the others about what needs to be done. And this is why what is important is not so much which party comes on top, but rather how these parties coming together in the coalition and in negotiating the coalition agreement offer space for thinking freely about these issues over the next parliamentary term.
Did I understand you right that you think the German parties have been too narrow in their thinking and that the next government needs to have a more European outlook? Is that what you're saying?
Yes, absolutely. I don't think the campaign has been discussing very much the sort of reforms that Europe needs. I don't think the campaign has discussed very much how, when, and why we should think of reforming the European treaties. and how these issues are going to impact German policies and politics. So I think these issues have been sadly slightly abandoned by all political parties. And what is striking is that there is a very intense debate taking place in Germany about European integration. And that debate is taking place inside the German Constitutional Court, but it's not taking place in politics more broadly. And I think that is a problem. Germany cannot afford that European policy is made by the German Constitutional Court and is not made by its elected officials.
And coming back to these priorities of the next upcoming 4 years, what are the three most important ones according to you? What should Germany do?
I think Germany should be candid about the fact that its own fiscal rules and the European fiscal rules are no longer fit for purpose, that they need to be reformed and that they need to be reformed quite profoundly. And that involves probably reforming the German constitution, but that also probably involves over time a changing European treaty. So that's one area. The second is to accept the idea that the euro area is an incomplete construction and that there is no stable single currency without a real centralized budget that can finance common policies, issue debt, and sometimes proceed to transfers between countries. We have seen the Europe doing it during this crisis, and I think that requires to make some of these steps and instruments permanent. And the third is to, I think, have an open mind about how monetary policy should evolve. Monetary policy of the good old days has changed. Monetary policy has to play a role in such things as financial stability, for which it doesn't have a clear mandate in the European treaties. It must play a role in climate change, for which it has a very modest mandate. And I think, you know, we have to think of monetary policy as being a much more active player in economic policy and as a player that will have to cooperate with fiscal policy a lot more than it has in the past 20 years.
And looking at the next 4 years, where is the first opportunity of the next German government to fulfill one of the goals you've just laid out?
The European Commission has laid out a plan for reforming the European fiscal rules. And that is supposed to come already at the end of 2021. So the new German government, very early at the end of 2021 or early in 2022, will have an opportunity to weigh on this debate in Brussels. Second, you know, there will be French elections also in May of 2022. And I think as soon as we have a new French government, I think there will be an opportunity between France and Germany to, you know, revive some of the discussions that have been taking place over the last 5 years and that have not been very conclusive. And then third, there will probably be a ruling by the German Constitutional Court, which will be followed by a ruling by the European Court of Justice on what is called the own resources decision. So that is the European piece of legislation that basically enables to raise common resources. And I think that will be an important legal decision that needs to be followed by government action in order to try and make the progress that we have seen during the COVID crisis permanent and maybe improve these instruments so that they can solidify the architecture of the euro area for the coming decades.
Yeah, dear Shahin, thank you for this look into the future. And even more of your thoughts are available at your DGAP Memo, which you find the link in the description below. And I'm looking forward to see you in our next interview on the upcoming German election.